Leia here from leiaforsci.com/MCAT, and in this video, I will show you how to do more advanced multiplication and division when you have multiple digits or multiple decimal spaces in your equation. In my last video, I showed you a simple trick for how to multiply and divide numbers that have a factor of 10 by moving the decimal to the right or the left. This trick can be taken a step further for more advanced questions such as this one. An elephant bumps a stone weighing 89 grams, giving it an initial acceleration of 213 meters per second squared. With how much force did the elephant hit the stone? At first glance, it seems like an easy question if only you had a calculator. I'll show you how to solve the question, then I'll break down the math trick. With any question like this, you have to look beyond the story and find the numbers that you're going to calculate. In this case, we're given 89 grams and 213 meters per second squared. In my physics videos, I'll break down the kinematic equations, showing you exactly when to use each formula. For now, let's just focus on the math. We're looking for force which is equal to mass times acceleration. So it looks like a simple plug-in, but be careful. Force has units of kilograms meter per second squared, and here we're given grams, so we first have to convert. I'm only writing out the conversion because I want you to see what I'm doing, but try to get comfortable doing this in your head. We have 89 grams, and we want to convert to kilograms. We know that 1 kilogram is equal to 1,000 grams, and we set it up as 1 over 1,000, allowing me to cancel out grams. In my last video, I showed you the trick. When you're dividing by 1,000 that has 3 zeros, you simply take the decimal and move it back 3 spaces. This gives me a new and usable number, 0.089 kilograms. Now I have the appropriate units, I can plug them in. 0.089 kilograms times 213 meters per second squared. We know the units are good because force is kilogram meter per second squared. Now let's do the math. 0.089 times 213 looks complicated, so let's start by simplifying. 89 is close to 90, so we'll change this number to 0.090. 213 is very close to 200, so we'll round that down. So we've simplified the question, but we still have the issue of numbers that we can't necessarily do in our head. So here's what I'm going to do. I'll take the first number and multiply it by 100. I'll take the second number divided by 100. This gives me 9 times 2, which I can certainly do in my head, and the answer is 18 newtons. Doing this on a calculator, I got the answer 18.957, which on the MCAT is just close enough. So let's break down this trick going through a series of step-by-step exercises. You already know that any number times 10 means that you move the decimal one space to the right, and any number divided by 10 means that you move the decimal one space to the left. There's another trick at work here. The second trick is multiplying a number by 1. 97 times 1 is 97. 100 times 1 is 100. Multiplying a number by 1 doesn't change the number. But the trick is being able to multiply by 1 when you see the number differently. For example, 1 over 1 is 1. 2 over 2 is not 2, it's still 1. 33 over 33 is 1. A green duck divided by a green duck is still 1. And the idea here is that it doesn't matter what form your number takes, as long as it's the same above and below the divisor, the answer is still 1. So for example, if I take something like 23 times 1 over 1, the answer is 23. 23 times 4.67 divided by 4.67 is still just 23, because I am simply multiplying 23 by 1. Okay, so let's take this one step further. If I have the equation 4 times 6 times 1 over 1, the answer is just 4 times 6. We're not actually solving that, I just want to show you that the identity doesn't change. Now if I take 4 times 6 and I multiply it by 10 over 10, it's still just 4 times 6. When you're multiplying and dividing, you can move the numbers around because the order of operations doesn't matter within multiplication and division. So watch. If I have 4 times 6 times 10 divided by 10, That's still 4 times 6 because I have times 10 divided by 10. That's 10 over 10. I can also write it as 4 times 6 times 10 times 1 over 10. One more time, I have times 10 divided by 10. And I can even write it as 4 times 6 times 10 divided by 10. This is the key. Notice that I took the two numbers that I initially started with, and I took one and multiplied by 10, and the other to divide by 10. That still gives me 4 times 6. Now let's try an application of this. Let's take a number that you can probably do in your head. Let's say I ask you to calculate 2 times 20. 2 times 20 is just 20 and 20, which is 40. So let's prove that using this trick still gives us 40. If I take the numbers 2 times 20 and then do times 10 and divided by 10, I should still have the answer 40. Let's prove it. 2 times 10 means we move the decimal one space to the right, giving me 20. 20 divided by 10, that means we move the decimal space one to the left, giving me 2. I have 20 times 2, which is still 40. Let's try something even more complicated. Let's take the number 0.05 times 400. This is something that you may come across and can't necessarily do in your head. But what if now, instead of times 10 divided by 10, we try times 100 divided by 100? What I'm trying to do, and how I choose where to put the multiplication and where to put the division, is take the big number and make it smaller, and take the small number and make it bigger. Specifically, I'm trying to get rid of the decimal because, let's face it, decimals are confusing. So if I take the 0.05 and I multiply that by 100, to make that fair, we have to take the 400 and divide it by 100. Because this way, I have times 100 divided by 100, and that means I'm not changing the total identity of the question. 0.05 times 100. 100 has two zeros, so I move the decimal two spaces to the right, giving me 5. Look at 400 divided by 100. 100 has two zeros, and because we're dividing, we move the decimal two spaces to the left. That gives me 4. Now, I don't know about you, but 0.05 times 400 is difficult. 5 times 4 is not. It's just 20. So what we did here was, instead of writing it out the long way, don't even write this out. On your MCAT, just mentally move the decimal to the right for the small number, to the left for the big number, by the same number of spaces. So watch me do this without even writing times 100 divided by 100. Here's how I would look at it if it was an MCAT question. 0.05 is too small. I move the decimal two spaces to the right. To make up for that, I move the big decimal two spaces to the left. 5 times 4, as we already said, is 20. Now let's go back to the initial question that we looked at. We had 0.090 times 200, and look at what we did. We moved the decimal from 0.09 two spaces to the right, giving me 9. We moved the decimal from 200 two spaces to the left, giving me 2. And without any long and detailed calculations, we know that 9 times 2 is 18, and that's how we quickly got our answer. Be sure to join me in the next video, where I show you how to apply a similar trick when it comes to negative and positive exponents. MCATExamStrategy.com